Buenos días y bienvenidos. Good morning. Welcome again to Tiempo. I'm Joe Torres. The Detective Rafael Ramos Foundation will hold a memorial toy drive in the next few days in Brooklyn. The toy drive will honor the fifth year anniversary of the deaths of NYPD officers Rafael Ramos and Wenjin Liu, who were fatally shot while sitting in their patrol car in Brooklyn. The foundation will honor their memory by once again giving back during the holiday season. And joining us, what a privilege, Maritza Ramos, the president, and Jose Falero, the vice president of the Detective Rafael Ramos Foundation. Welcome back to Tiempo, right? Because it was 2 years ago for the first give back, right? So this is year three?
This is the third year.
Has it gotten bigger and better in the last...
Every year has grown, and it has been more memorable every time.
What have you learned personally throughout this process?
I've learned that people are very giving, mm-hmm. and there's so many people that are willing to help our cause.
And your cause, and we'll get to the mission in just a second, mm-hmm. but what is the ultimate goal, the overreaching goal out of this?
My ultimate goal is to bring the community and the police together. Mm-hmm. And the reason I do schools and young children is because I believe that them being so young mm-hmm. is where they're impacted the most.
Yeah, that's the time to strike.
That's the time to strike.
Yeah, when they're impressionable.
Exactly.
Before decisions have been made in their lives.
I want them to see police officers in a light of doing something positive.
Yep. So that their first confrontation with an officer is not a negative one.
It's not a negative one.
No.
Exactly.
Jose, how long have you been with the organization now? Well, since the beginning?
Since the very beginning.
Yeah.
4 years now.
And you knew Detective Ramos before the tragedy of 5 years ago?
Me and Rafael, we served in the same church. Mm-hmm. We went to the same church, and we knew each other's family.
Okay. The toy drive, how special is it? I would assume nothing beats seeing the faces of the kids when they get a toy, a backpack.
You know,
whatever.
Out of all the things that we do, that is probably the most favorite event that we do, because seeing the smiles on all the kids' faces, seeing them interact with the officers, seeing them being so excited to receive presents from us, mm-hmm. is totally, totally something that I totally cherish.
How many officers get involved in the day on the drive?
On the day of?
Yeah.
I would say we have more than 50.
My goodness, really?
Sometimes, yes.
From all parts of the city, or largely in Queens or in Brooklyn?
Brooklyn, mostly Brooklyn, but there's people that come out to help from all over.
Okay. Where do you get the toys to donate to the kids?
Well, we do a fundraiser every year, mm-hmm. and we did one last year, and it was very successful.
Okay.
And we're doing it again this year, November 13th? No, December 13th, December 13th, right. Lot 45 in Brooklyn.
Wow. And the first year was backpacks. Has it become more than backpacks? I mean, what kind of toys are you giving away?
Okay, so we have all sorts of toys, and mm-hmm. people donate.
Yep.
I mean, the LOL, that's very popular.
Yes.
Last year, all the kids were loving that.
This year,
I didn't even know what it was until last year.
Ahora sabe.
Yeah.
This year, it's PS65?
PS65. It's actually a block away, well, 2 blocks away from where I live.
Okay.
Currently, where I lived with my husband.
And has it always been PS65?
No, we adopt a different school every year.
Okay. I mean, how do you go about picking what school will be the beneficiary of this drive?
We kind of, like, wait for people to reach out to us, but mm-hmm. we also... Well, this year I kind of did it in this school because of the location of it.
Yes.
And it being our home.
Mm-hmm. And you do the fundraiser to purchase the toys to be distributed to the kids.
Yes.
Who gets to go on the shopping spree to buy all the toys?
Oh, man. We all of us, it's a team effort. Yeah. We all go out there and we try to reach the community, and we try to get people to come aboard and help us. Usually people come to our fundraiser and they bring the toys to us.
I was going
to
say, I mean, are you at the point where you don't need to buy the toys anymore, where a lot of people are contributing?
Yes, there are a lot of people contributing toys to us, mm-hmm. which is awesome, because then we can use the other funds to bring in bouncy houses mm-hmm. and other fun things for the kids to have on that day where we give the toys out.
Maritza, how many kids do you think you'll be able to provide a toy with?
We're hoping for 1,000 this year.
Wow.
Ugh.
What was it last year? I mean, is that bigger and better than last year?
Last year was about 700, I believe. Yes. It was about 700.
Well, 700. Mm-hmm.
So every year we're hoping to maybe do more than one school.
And these are kids, well, at a public school, 65, it's kids ranging in age from what to what?
4 to maybe...
Yeah.
11?
Yeah, 11, 12.
12.
All right, when we come back, I want to ask you a little bit more about the mission of the foundation and how that's moving along. So sit tight. When we come back, more on the Detective Rafael Ramos Foundation. Welcome back to Tiempo. The Detective Rafael Ramos Foundation will hold a memorial toy drive in a few days in Brooklyn. The toy drive honors the fifth anniversary of the deaths of NYPD officers Rafael Ramos and Wenjin Liu. They were fatally shot as they sat in their patrol car. The foundation will once again honor them and their memory by giving back this holiday season. And joining us this morning, once again, Maritza Ramos, the president, and Jose Falero, the vice president of the Detective Rafael Ramos Foundation. I wanted to get back to not just the toy drive, but the mission of the foundation is really to bring together the community and law enforcement. And this question is for both of you, so get your answer ready next. In the last 5 years since your husband's death, have you seen that relationship improve?
I want to say yes.
I know you do.
But at this point right now, it's a little scary. Mm-hmm. And this is why I feel like I need to work a lot harder. Mm-hmm. In my mission to...
Does it make events like the toy drive and the mission of the foundation even more important. Needed and yes. important? Yes.
To me, it does make it more important. Mm-hmm.
You're the guy on the street. Same question. What's the relationship like now in the 5 years since his death? Is it any better? Are we on the road to improvement, my friend?
We definitely have our work cut out for us.
Yes.
It definitely could be better. I mean, I think when we do our events, we see a difference and we see the appreciation the community has. But we do have a long way to go. Mm-hmm. And it makes our mission even more important that mm-hmm. we get out there and we just try to bring both sides together and in a positive event mm-hmm. rather than something tragic happening.
And there's no doubt the toy drive is a positive event. You know, and you said 50 police officers will be involved in part of the drive itself.
The
and then
least.
Community members from Por Donde Quiera, right?
Yes, they come out and show their support.
Now, for Tiempo viewers who want to contribute, how can they do that? At the toy drive. I mean, is it open to the public where I could drive up in my pickup truck and say, aquí tengo un montón de juguetes?
We're definitely not turning away anyone.
Okay, so you can come.
Open to the public.
Do you want the toys wrapped? Do you want them open? Either way.
We don't wrap them because okay. we want to know if it's a boy toy or a girl toy.
Sure.
When we're giving them away.
Okay. So. And have you seen the community in years past open themselves up in esa manera where they're bringing toys to give
definitely,
to the kids?
Definitely, definitely. Yeah. I'm very blessed in seeing that our community has supported us completely. Mm-hmm.
And we should mention, and I'll let you get into this a little bit, it's more than just a toy drive. You got some celebrities attending as well. I'll throw the names out and you tell me how excited you are. Amanda Serrano, I mean, and she's been here on Tiempo before.
Amazing.
A pioneer.
Yes.
You want to tell the folks who she is?
Amanda Serrano, she is a world-class boxer, mm-hmm. Holds the Guinness World Book of Records for the most titles ever held by a woman, historic Latina from Puerto Rico.
Male or female? Both. I mean, she's at the top.
She's at the top. She's had multiple championships. She's amazing. We have other people like Joseph Sikora from the show Power. Mm-hmm. We have
J.W.
Cortez.
Our good friend here on Tiempo. Yep.
That's my favorite celebrity out of all of them.
Tell him J.W. Cortez is an actor. He's also a fellow police officer.
Yes, he is. He's also a combat veteran.
Yep.
He's a philanthropist. But most of all, he's a great family man, and mm-hmm. he's really important to our foundation.
Freestyle artist Rockwell, right, will be there as well.
Yes.
Are you at the point where the celebrities are coming to you to say, I want to be part of this?
We have had people call us and say that they want to be a part of our cause.
And some men and women in uniform. Participating, tell me about them.
Yes, we have the NYPD jazz band. Mm-hmm. They're going to come out and they're going to perform some hits that some of us may recognize. And they're amazingly talented. The NYPD is full of talented officers, and we just love highlighting that. And people can come and witness how talented our officers.
All right, where to go and when? Let's put it up on the full screen so everybody can see it. Here it is, Friday, December 13th, so roughly about 2 weeks, 7 p.m. 411 Troutman Street in Brooklyn. Get back to Brooklyn. In Brooklyn there. And again, it's 7 o'clock and there's no fee, right? Doors are open. Come by.
There is a fee.
Yes. There is a fee to attend, yes. But if you want to donate, I'm sure you can.
If you want to bring toys, you can come toys. There won't be a fee for that. But if you want to enjoy the entertainment and support the cause, it's a $35 fee with a toy.
And starts at 7?
Starts at 7.
Hasta qué hora?
Until 12 o'clock.
Yes. Yeah. She gave me a sign like this, which means se acaba cuando se termina cuando se termina. But it's always a good time. Continued success to you. And
thank
you know, you are forever in the hearts of New Yorkers. And this, by the way, we should mention this. We got 30 seconds. This is what your husband would have wanted,
definitely.
Correct? Because his whole life was
to give back
to the community. So, you know, I get the feeling and the impression, and perhaps you do too, that he's watching from above saying,
"Qué bueno." I sure hope so.
Yes. Oh, no doubt. Yes. I can reassure you with that. Okay. Thank you, guys.